Thanks to Brilliant for supporting this episode of SciShow. Go to brilliant.org/scishow to learn more. The Congo River is one of the largest rivers in the world, stretching across thousands of kilometers of Africa. And the last 300-kilometer stretch of the river, referred to as the Lower Congo River, empties into the Atlantic Ocean in an incredibly dramatic way. Turbulent and treacherous rapids, and it is deep, too. But as inhospitable as it may seem, over 300 species of fish are thriving in the Lower Congo River, and many are found nowhere else on Earth, including some that are frankly bizarre. For these fish, in a sense, the Lower Congo isn't one river. It's a bunch of isolated habitats. Incredibly powerful rapids, separated by stretches of calm water, have kept fish populations apart long enough that they can't breed with one another. The isolation causes new species to evolve side by side, a process called allopatric speciation. Normally, it's caused by much larger barriers, like a mountain range. But in the Lower Congo, some of these populations are only separated by a kilometer or so. And this isolation is also happening in 3D. The Congo is the deepest river in the world, measured at over 200 meters deep in places. That's roughly equivalent to a 60-story building. And researchers have discovered one fish species that is seemingly so isolated from the surface in deep underwater canyons that it's led to some extreme adaptations. There's a species of cichlid that, unlike its colorful aquarium cousins, shares characteristics with fish found in caves. For one thing, they have no pigment. Delightfully, the local fishermen refer to these weird pale fish as Mondeli Bureau, which translates to white man in an office. We're like me! And their eyes are basically non-functional, underdeveloped, and covered in skin. And when they come to the surface, these cichlids rapidly die of decompression sickness. But it's not just cichlids that are blind, white, and weird-looking in the Lower Congo. This river is also a perfect place to study convergent evolution. That refers to the way species that aren't closely related can evolve very similar adaptations because of the conditions they're in. Pale, blind species of distantly related fish have been found in the river, including the cichlid, along with elephant fish, members of different catfish families, and spiny eels. We're talking so distantly related that they are as genetically distinct as armadillos are from blue whales. These characteristics developing in caves make a lot of sense. They're pretty dark, after all. But aside from the cichlid, these cave-like fish are found alive, which means they don't have the same deep water adaptations and are likely living somewhere a lot shallower. Discovering these species tells us that there are likely other low-light microhabitats in the river, and that they're stable and isolated enough to drive the evolution of low-light adapted species. But while the strange fish that live in the Lower Congo can tell us a lot about how the river's conditions are driving evolution, it's such a dangerous place for humans that there's still a lot we don't know, like where exactly these fish are living. We're really just starting to piece together a bigger picture of what's going on there. Hydrologists, geologists, and ichthyologists are working together to better understand the unique biodiversity, geology, and hydrology of the river. And there are still tons of questions to answer, like what genes are driving the evolution of these cavefish characteristics. It could be the same ones each time, or totally different ones producing similar outcomes. So while we don't know yet, these researchers are working hard to find out. This research is super collaborative, the product of lots of research from multiple institutions working together. So it's a good thing great scientists think alike. You too can learn the language of science with Brilliant's in-depth course on scientific thinking. It's a course that uses various problems to give you an intuitive feel for the laws of physics and the principles of engineering. Brilliant offers loads of courses to help you hone your STEM skills, from math to computer science to engineering. Each one has interactive elements to help you learn. And right now, you can save 20% off an annual premium subscription if you're one of the first 200 people to sign up at brilliant.org/scishow. So you can head over there and keep on learning.